All right, class, this is number 39 in the book. Okay, here's the data. One, as the number of hours increases, the number of bacteria is going up significantly. So you would use a let's see what happens when you use a linear regression here. So if I go to calculate and I go to just a linear regression, I have L1 and L2, and I want to store the regression line, vars, y vars, function, y1. Okay? And I hit enter. Okay, now I want this to show up in the window, so I want to go a little bit smaller than my smallest number. I'll go 0 and 8 and scale, doesn't matter, 1. We'll go 150 here, a little bit smaller. We'll go 5,000, a little bit bigger, and I'll just have these go up by 500s. Okay, hit graph. Okay, so if you notice, we have a couple above, and then it goes below, and then it goes back above. So this would be an indication. If I did a residual plot, which we haven't done, but you did it in the online. We've never actually done it ourselves, but we did it. We saw it in the online. We saw it in the assignment. What would the residual plot look? It'd be this line horizontally, and then these differences would be plotted. So we'd have a point above, a point a little above. We'd have 4 points below, and then we'd have another point above. So this would have a pattern as it doesn't fluctuate, okay? So it would show that a linear regression is not a good model for this. So there are some other models we can try. For example, problem number 39, it wants us to use A, B to the X, and see if this matches up with the data. Okay, A, B to the X. That's called I'll quit out of this. That's actually in the calculator. It is the X reg. So exponent regression line. Okay, so if I hit enter here, L1, L2, and again, I'm gonna store it, because, I don't know, just crazy like that. So store it, Y1, hit enter here, and there we go. So here would be our A value, here would be our B value to the X. This gives us a 0.99 correlation. This is extremely high. So it looks like this one does line up pretty good with our data. We can check the graph. Again, I already have it in the window here. So if I go to the graph, and look at that, it's almost exactly on this line. So this is a really good representation for this problem, okay? The book goes over another way you can do this problem instead of expreg, okay? It says you can take the log of each of these values, so log of L2, okay? Hit enter, okay? And then you get these values, and then you can graph L1 and L3, and you're gonna end up in the same spot. I just think the other way is a little bit easier. Okay, so that's number 39. You're also going to find a couple problems like it online. Hope this helps.